Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Shraddha's Physics. This video is specially for the aspirants who are preparing for OSSTT, KVS, NVS, regular teacher or any graduate level teacher exam.
This is all for the problem related to circular motion. The question is, a small body is tied to a point by inextensible string of negligible mass and is rotated in a circle of radius 5 meters in the vertical plane. Okay. So, what is the least speed that it must have at the uppermost point of the circle so that the string doesn't slacken? And the next part is calculate the speed at the lowest point. So, first of all, the for motion in a vertical circle, the minimum velocity at the highest point is v equal to zr root over. If you want to calculate all these things, then you may follow the book, or you have to simply, I am telling that you have to simply recall this formula, because at the time of exam you will not get that much of time to solve. So v is gr root over. So for the vertical circle, the minimum velocity. In the last class we have seen, so for the cyclist at a vertical circle, the minimum velocity at the lowest point is 5 gr root over. So here at the highest point, that is the lowest point at the lowest point, that is 5 gr root over. Here at the highest point it is gr root over. So g is 9.8 and r is given 5 meters. So 9.8 into 5, that is 7 meter per second, after calculating taking the square root. So velocity at the lowest point is 5 gr root over. So that will becomes this much. Okay. At the highest point it is gr root over, and the lowest point the velocity will be 5 gr root over. That's it. The next question is, a motorcyclist loops the loop whose radius is 8 meter. From what minimum height must he start in order to roll down and go around the loop? So here the radius of the loop is given 8 meter. So the potential energy at height h is mgh, we know, and the kinetic energy at the bottom we know, and that will be half mv square, where v will be the velocity required at the bottom. So from the conservation energy principle, the kinetic energy will be equal to the potential energy, that is half mv square will be equal to mgh. So gradually the kinetic energy will convert to the potential energy, or the vice versa we can say. So in the conservation, this is the conservation principle. So here by cancelling the mass m, we will get v square will be 2gh, or simply putting the values of g, that is 9.8, and here h is not given, so this is 2 into 9.8 into h. So for completing a loop of vertical circle, so this will be v square equal to 5 gr. At the lowest point, this will be v square equal to 5 gr. So v square is 2 into 9.8 into h. We have already calculated here. So by putting this, and g value is 9.8 and r is 8. So by putting all the values and cancelling 9.8 from the both side, we will get h equal to 20 meter. So that is, this height is 20 meter. So this is the minimum height so that the cyclist must start in order to roll down and go around the loop. So the next question is, a body of mass 1.25 kg hangs at the end of a string. Okay. String length is 1 meter and is held in a vertical circle at a constant speed of 8 meter per second. So determine the tension in the string when the body is at the lowest point and at the highest point. So A is the lowest point and B is the highest point. Here what is given, that is mass is 1.25 kg and the radius or the length of the string is 1 meter. Okay. So velocity is 8 meter per second, it is also given. So first of all, at the lowest point, that is at this point A, so the weight is mg and the tension, that is T1, is acting here. So there are two forces. One is mg acting downward, and T1 the tension along the AO, or we can say that it is in the upward direction. So the centripetal force is mb square by r, which is balanced by this tension and the weight. So the T1 is upward direction, mg in the downward direction. So one is positive T1 minus mg. Since the centripetal force will always act towards the center, so this will be positive. If we will consider this direction is positive, mb square by r, so also T1 also positive. So T1 will be mb square by r. So this will be plus mg, mg is on the right hand side. So by putting all these values, we will get 92.25 newton, that is the tension of the string at this point. So the next is, at the highest point, the tension is, let us consider this tension is T2 in the downward direction. And also MG acting in the downward direction and also the tension in the downward direction at this highest point. So this T2 plus MG, since they are both in the same direction, so this is T2 plus MG, which is balanced by MB square by R, that is the centripetal force. So T2 will be equal to MB square by R minus MG. So by putting all this value, MB square by R, it is calculated 80. So by putting all this value, we'll directly calculate. After solving, we have calculated this is 67.75 Newton. So at the highest point, this much, and at the lowest point, this much. So this is all for today. Thank you.